Hi, my name is Kent. I'm the Creative Specialist on the Google Web Designer team, and I'd like to show how to use text effects in Google Web Designer. If you don't see the panel, it can be enabled in the Window menu. I'll start a new file and note that text effects work in all file types except AMP and Image. I'll create a banner, zoom in to make this a little easier to see, then create a text element, key in some text, and apply some basic styles. In the Text Effects panel, select an effect to preview it right in the panel. And each change is previewed again. Make sure the text element is selected, and with the text effect selected, click the plus icon to apply it. And now you'll see a whole panel of options specific to each effect. Check the help doc listed in the description for a complete list of all the effects and their properties. You can get a quick idea of what each control does using the preview. Hover over it to expose playback and loop controls. For example, by default I see a smooth gradient from left to right as each letter is revealed. But if I change the gradient angle, now I see more of a cascade effect. On the stage, note the text has disappeared. Scrub the playhead to see the animation. Also note a new layer for the effect is added below the text, but it's a special kind of layer. It just holds the effect span. It stays attached to the text layer and it can't be moved or adjusted independently. The span can be used to edit the effect timing, so I could drag it out to have it start later, and I can grab either end to change the duration, which is also the same as editing this field numerically in the panel. Note the span is highlighted yellow when selected, and in this state you're editing the effect instance, like changing the starting opacity from 0, or even changing the applied effect. Or hit the delete key to remove the effect but leave the text. You can also add multiple effects to the same element. First, I'll update the colors to white text on black. Then move the playhead to 1 second, which is when I want the effect to start, and with the text element selected, go back to blur and apply it. Shorten to a half second. This time I'll change the sequence to all at once. Note this time you can see the text already, before the animation starts. That's because opacity is 100. Blur is the only effect with this starting value, so I'll change it to 0, which means the text is hidden before the animation. I want to hold for a second and a half, so move the playhead to 3. Deselect the span by clicking either layer, although the text is still selected. And now apply another effect. I'll just use blur again, but I could use any, and make the same adjustments to duration, opacity, and sequence. Although this time I want it to animate off a little slower, so I'm increasing the duration to 3/4 of a second. And now this time I'll select reverse, which animates the effect off screen instead of on. Then use stage playback to show the result. Transition on, hold to read, transition off. Another trick here is to reduce the blur from a default 5 pixels to 0, which means no blur, but still keeps the animation opacity, and repeat for the outgoing span. And now I've got a super basic text animation with no keyframes, which 9 times out of 10 meets my needs. This becomes really useful when working with responsive files, which again seems like all the time. I'll zoom out a little to show the whole ad, use this responsive panel checkbox to make the file responsive, and click the next size, which right away is one of the harder ones, the skyscraper. Move the playhead to any point where you can see the text and make the adjustments. In this case, I think I'll center the text and reduce the width, allowing it to wrap. Then open the responsive preview panel, rewind, and playback. And that whole authoring process is so much easier this way because I don't have to fuss around with the keyframes, like accidentally creating new ones, or needing to move the playhead to a position where the element is hidden before I can change it. This is a huge workflow improvement if you're working with responsive animated text, and I use this all the time now. And speaking of responsive, I can change all the text effects properties for this one size only as responsive overrides, such as changing the timing or even the effect. I'll make this first span much longer, and the second span start later. Then change the outgoing effect to flip, and now I have completely different text animations on these two responsive sizes. Of course, you can still use keyframes if you like, and in combination with text effects. I return to the main size and choose Edit Base Document, so I'm authoring all sizes at once, and set a couple keyframes, one just before and one just after these text effects. Then use the Properties panel to create a very slowly shrinking animation with a 0.9 uniform scale. Then rewind and playback to see the more complex animation in all sizes. And in case you're about to ask, of course, this supports dynamic content. So while still editing the base document, open the Dynamic Bindings panel and click this icon to create a new binding. I'll use the standard schema, brand awareness, select my text element, bind its text content to the additional text object, and click OK. Then on the Sample Data tab, select this default variant, which of course I could customize to my own text, and now we've got dynamic content. Lastly, I want to show a few finished examples highlighting some different effects and properties. First up is scroll, which I call the Star Wars effect in this case, although you can adjust the settings for different results. I've got a star field image in the background and a simple text element on top with my styled content. Note the text toward the top of the container fades out smoothly, which happens automatically. It's built into the effect. Here's my text content, which I've set to justify in the text panel. There's font and style changes in the headline, and it overflows the container now for editing. Like all effects, they're temporarily turned off for text editing. During playback, the animation is constrained to the container size. The scroll effect has a longer 20-second duration, which is past the slider range, but can be entered numerically. And the main control here is type set to vanishing point for this effect. The next example shows two options available to all other effects, easing and randomize order. My text content is wide-tracked and uses three subtle style changes for color and font. I've applied the flip effect with the randomize order checkbox selected so the letters appear out of sequence. And I have all these easing options, including custom curves. I've used ease in slow so the effect gets a lot of attention at the beginning and then zips through the remainder. And one final example to show the speed and sequence controls, which we've already seen used letter by letter and all at once. This example animates on word by word and animates off line by line, each with a different effect. The incoming animation uses the lineup effect with sequence set to word by word. The grouping size of one means one word at a time, and the direction is set to from bottom. The outgoing effect is slide, set to line by line, again with grouping size for single lines and reverse for a transition off screen. Direction is from right, easing this time is ease in out, and the speed control can be thought of as the overlap between groups, or lines in this case, with zero meaning no delay or all lines at once, and one meaning each line animates completely before the next line starts. And the really nice part about this is that of course these divisions are set dynamically, so for whatever text content you use, the automatic text wrapping defines the lines of animation. I've really just scratched the surface of what's possible with text effects, and it's certainly worth a closer look to explore on your own. That's it for text effects in Google Web Designer. Thanks for watching.